Hey friends, happy Thursday. We are gonna paint a cute little chicken set. It goes with all the new little inserts, and we're gonna do a cute little bucket today. So we're gonna work on both of these projects. I'm just gonna jump right in. So tipping you down here so that we can go ahead and get started. These are listed on the website. So this is going to be one of the new sitters that goes with all of the little interchangeables for the baskets. And I just grabbed out a couple of different grays. I've got dark gray, my super dark gray, so pavement, almost a black. Let's see what we got here. Pewter gray. And then I also have sterling silver that I'm going to use on here. So let me show you those colors. There you go. Three different grays right there. Oops, just stuck a yellow paint chip in there. And hey Vicky, hi Dorothy. Cut up some of my sponges here. All right, I think I'm gonna use this big one though. It's a big background, and I think I'm gonna use silver for most of, oh, you know what? I forgot. I should have put white on here first. We're not gonna do that. We're gonna put the gray on here. So I'm gonna use this darker gray, the pewter gray. Maybe I will mix it with some white still. I just feel like the white helps give it some color, and then it'll give it some dimension too. Not color. I guess color. Makes it stick out better. The lighter grays don't cover very good, so it just gives it better coverage. So right now, again, I'm going over it with the pewter gray and white, and then I'll go back over it again with that silver in a minute. And I'm just using a big sponge. With that, oops, try and straighten out my strokes there a little bit. Hi Tracy, hi Terry. I'm gonna smooth that out, set that aside a second. So then you'll notice you have one that says back on it, and then you'll have a front. This is because it's creating the little slot there for the inserts. Hi Barbara, welcome. So let's go ahead, and I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna use the darker gray with some white. So this time I'm using the pavement color with white. I'm not going to color this one in. It's going to the back. I'm going to color this one in. I'm just trying to smooth out. I would call them brush strokes, but it's from the sponge. And I think I'm going to leave that like that. I actually really like that color. It just kind of gives it a little bit of dimension. This will get glued onto the back. See how it creates that little spot there? That's how the inserts will fit. All right, so I'm going to set this over here. And then I'm going to paint this piece the same way. So a little bit of white and then the dark gray or pavement color. This is just going to be the base that it sits in. It gives it that good, like, metal-y color, which is what I'm looking for since it's a bucket. So then this is going to be the little handle. I'm going to do this, I think, in the same color, too. So the dark pavement and some white mixed. It's not even mixed all the way. They're just kind of semi-blended. There we go. See what I do? I literally have a little bit of both on there. It's not mixed. That's what gives it kind of the dimension and makes it look a little bit more real because it's not completely mixed. I'm going to do a second coat on this part of it. And I think on the main part of the bucket too. And then I do still want to try to put a little bit of silver on the main bucket as well. We'll see how that works out. Plus I have the darker on there too. I wasn't thinking about that. That's all right. I could switch it around. Like, could flop the sponge around if I wanted to. I'm not going to worry about it. I'm going to dip it into my lighter gray with the white again. It's got some of the darker gray on there, which is fine. I need more white. I'm having a hard time covering my edges. There we go. Promise, we're going to get to some fun stuff in a second here. The chicken part will be better. The bucket's a little bit boring, but we got to get the bucket done so that we can stick the chicken in the bucket. All right, I'm not worried about going all the way up because that is going to be covered with our 3D pieces. This is getting in my way. Roll up my sleeves a little here. All right, and then I'm going to grab some of the silver paint, which is just sterling silver Folgart. And I'm going to put this on here as well. Oh yeah, I like that. That's nice and shiny. I think that gives it even more of a metal bucket look. Oops, got a little bit of that dark gray on there. That's okay. All right, I'm going to set this off to the side. Look how that's still going to stick out, okay? So I'm going to set that over there and all these pieces over here. And then we're going to go ahead and just doing a second coat on this base real quick. All right, so now the bucket is done. We can move on to our chicken. Hi, Pam. Hi, Linda. I think, nope, I didn't. I was going to say, I think I just put paint all over my face. Okay, check out this cute little insert. It is a little chicken. I'm gonna find, let's see, I've got one right here, a little paintbrush. So it says farm fresh eggs, and it's just a cute little chicken on top of its little basket of eggs, or in this case, it's gonna be a bucket of eggs. How is everybody doing tonight? All right, let's see, where do I wanna start? I think we're gonna start with painting just our chicken. So I'm gonna get some white on here. And my chickens are not regular chickens. I have silky chickens, so I have to kind of think about how this chicken's supposed to look. Mine are like the little hairy chickens. I'm just gonna paint this whole part white to start with. It's not all gonna stay white, but it's gonna be easier for me to go over the other parts with color than it is to try and just stay in my lines. So I'm gonna do this to start. This part down here is gonna have 3D piece over it, so I'm not worried about that. I just went a little bit over the lines, that's fine. And I'm gonna let that dry a second, and I am gonna hit it with a second coat. I'm gonna go over here though and do my eggs in a coat of white, because even the ones that I'm gonna do in color, I think I'm gonna do light colors. So it'll just give me a good base. I got a big glob of white paints between there. There we go. Hi, Deborah. Hello, Penny. Hi, hi. How is everybody? Hi, Joni. All right. I think that's dry enough to do a second coat on the main parts of the chicken that I want to have covered in white. So I'm going to go back through here, and I'm just going to run some white paint. Second coat on this part of the chicken. And then after I get the base on there, I do kind of dab it in. I like that look better than the streaky look. I'm just gonna clean up my side again with my brush. All right. So then this part's gonna be our chicken part. Let's do nutmeg brown. Hi, Deborah. Hello, Shauna. All right. So I'm just going to give them a little brown to his head here. Sorry if you hear my dumb dogs upstairs barking. All right, so there we go. And then we'll give him his eyeball in a little bit. So we're gonna give him his little beak. I'm gonna use my paintbrush for that because it's just a tiny, tiny piece. I'm gonna use some King's Gold. Actually, I don't think King's Gold exists anymore. I think that it's now Golden Sunset. But I bought a ton of paint years ago and I haven't used it all yet. Can you believe that? I bought a ton of paint. Just before COVID, actually, I bought so much paint because I wasn't able to get out of the house very much at that time. And then COVID hit, so I was glad I bought all the paint I did. And I just bought way more than I really ever needed, probably. All right, so giving him his little beak. And then he's gonna have his little red parts here. And up top. Anybody else have chickens? I had 16. One of them didn't make it. And then we're not allowed to have roosters, so I did just get rid of 6 of them. Right, I think I'm down to 9 chickens. They're all silkies. I've got 1 splash, 1 red one, a white one, and then the rest of them are all gray. Blue, they call them blue, they're gray. All right, oh my gosh, he's gonna be cute. Let me clean off this. Vicky's got chicken. How many chickens you got, Vicky? 4 roosters and 3 hens, Penny. Awesome. I do still have roosters. I didn't get rid of all of them. I think there's 3 of them out there, but I got rid of the majority of them, so that should count, right? We live on 10 acres in the middle of, like, nowhere, so not in the middle of nowhere, but way off the road. Nobody's out here, so they don't know that we have roosters. Unless you guys tell on me. Don't tell on me. All right, just give him a little black spot for the eye, and I'm gonna move that out of the way. And then let's go over here and work on our 3D pieces. We've got his little tail and his wing here. I think those are just gonna be done in white too. Where'd that white sponge go? Here we go. At least to start, maybe I'll change the color after we get them all together, but. Or our base is done, I guess I should say. Had the same breed. They didn't do good, oh no. I hope mine do okay over the winter because we can have really nasty winters. They've got a really nice house. They should be okay. And I'll bring them inside if I have to. My family might not agree with bringing them inside, but I'll bring them inside. They can stay in my bed. Maybe not for real, but I hope they do okay. All right, let's see here. So this I'm gonna do in like yellow too, but I don't want it all yellow. So let's see, where's my, I thought I had another brush out here. I'm gonna go back with that same yellow, mustardy yellow, is what I call it. And I'm gonna go all around the whole thing here. This is like my hay or straw or whatever bedding you put in your chicken coop for your chickens to lay their eggs on. So that's what's with the background here. I think I'm just gonna mix it in. I got black on this, don't I? I'm gonna mix in with a little bit of that nutmeg. And just kind of, I don't know how I'm gonna do it, just kind of throw some splashes of the nutmeg in there just to kind of give it some more dimension and make it look a little bit more like straw, I guess, or hay. whatever you got in your chicken coop. See what I did there? It's not completely blended. I just kind of give it a different color, I guess. Hi, Deborah. Hello, Cindy. Hi, Sheila. All right. So these will go on here. We still got to paint these eggs, which we'll do in just a second before we move these on. But I think that makes it look more like the actual bedding instead of that bright yellow. I mean, it's not even a bright yellow, but it looks bright compared to this. So that's why I did that. Let's do a layer of white on these eggs. Oops, I ran out of white again. All right, so white coat, I'm gonna let that sit. And then I'm gonna use my brush, I think, at least to start. I got out a couple of different colors. So chicken eggs can be all sorts of different colors, but I got out a light blue, got out a tannish color, which is warm buff. And then I got out marshmallow, toasted marshmallow, which is just a creamy color. I thought those would be pretty good egg colors, just to give us a little variety. Go ahead with this one. I'm just going to paint this whole area. This is the, what was it? Warm buff? Warm buff. It's going to have the 3D piece on it, so I'm not worried about going over the lines. I'm just going to paint the whole area. I'm just kind of smoothing it out. I don't want it to have any bumps. Hello, Wendy. And then I'm going to pick, what do we got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'm going to do a couple more eggs in this color. I'm going to do this one just so I'm not rinsing my brush out or changing colors every other one and smearing them. Just going to stick with the same color all and then switch to the next color. And then I think one more of this one right here. And then I'll do the same colors on the 3D eggs, but we'll do those in a second. Oh, this one's got red sticking through here. That's all right. Okay, and then I'll switch to my, I'll do some blue ones. How about for a minute? I'll just do two blue ones and two of the cream ones. I'm excited to put the basket, or not the basket, it's not a basket, it's called a bucket, to put the bucket together and get this on there. I'll do this one in blue too. See, if we wouldn't have put that white behind there, these would, especially this blue, just would take a couple of coats to show up, but I feel like with the white on there, it just gives it a very, very light blue, which is what I was looking for. I don't want it to be too dark or too bright, but we also want it to show up. All right, so then I'm switching to the toasted marshmallow for my last color. And then I'll show you the other ones. I think I have two other ones. Oh, my foot's falling asleep. Two other of the interchangeable bases finished that I can show you how they change out. And I did link the collection for the interchangeables in the description of the video so you can find them easier. All right. Look at the cute little eggs. They just look like they just belong there. Like it fits perfect. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to try to switch to a sponge for a minute to do these eggs. Let's do our blue one in the middle. Or should we do a blue one on the end? Let's do a blue one on the end over here. And then we'll do our darker one in the middle. Not that it's really that much darker, just a slight difference. And then our lighter toasted marshmallow on the very end one. So my chickens aren't laying eggs yet, but they gotta be close. My ducks have been for a couple of weeks now. Oops, what did I just do? I think I hit FaceTime on my computer. But yeah, so the ducks are laying eggs, the chickens are not yet, but they gotta be close. They're about a month younger, so I say any time now. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and get out my glue, and I like to use the Stick Fast. Everybody always asks. I get this on Amazon. It is the thick, right? Yes, thick. If you get the, it says CA thick right there. If you get the thin stuff, it's really watery. But if they don't have thick, I would order the thin still. You just gotta be very careful with it. Gonna set this off to the side to dry there a minute. Let's set our chicken aside, go back to our bucket for a minute and start putting that together. So again, I'm gonna take my glue. And this piece goes on the front. And then the piece that says back will go on the other side, but we'll do that after this is dried completely so that we don't let that slide anywhere. The base doesn't have to be glued. You can glue your base if you want to. Sometimes I do, sometimes I don't. And then this, I'll show you something here in a second that you should be able to do. This is gonna go in here, but it's got a little give to it. You gotta be careful because you'll break the MDF, but you can stretch it behind there if you want to so that it looks just like that. Or you can leave it. I'm gonna leave mine because I don't wanna sit and hold it while it dries. You'd wanna probably hold it down. If I can get any glue out of here. So either way, it's gonna look cute either way, but I'm not gonna wait for it to dry. So I'm just gonna set it like this. It still looks like it's 3D, but if you want that behind there, you can do that. Actually, I'm gonna leave it like that. It feels like the, I'm gonna hold it for 2 seconds. Should hold it down, it seems like. Okay, so then, make sure I don't get any glue in that middle spot at all, so that way you can stick your insert in right away and not have to worry about it sticking in there. And then I just stick that right on there. Oops. And then I set it off to the side to dry so that nothing slides around like it's going to do for a second here. There's the little slot right there where the inserts will go. All right, back to our chicken. Got our cute little farm fresh sign here. Let's do this and nutmeg. I like to do nutmeg a lot for like a light wood color. It's not terribly different than the MDF that it's cut from. And I'm gonna do a little bit different or a little bit darker. Maybe if I can find a little bit darker. I got melted chocolate. And we're gonna use that for this part of it, like the stick part. All again, just to give it a little bit more dimension. And I'm gonna glue it down right on here. I hear Preston running downstairs. There we go. So you don't really see a huge difference between the two colors anyways, but I'm gonna set this off to the side. And then we're gonna get, oh, I have maybe enough white. Get out some more white and do our letters in white. So the Farm Fresh Eggs will be in white. It will stick off the sign nice and bright, easy to read. These are very, very thin and breakable, so be very careful with them. I thought he was coming in here, but I hear him running back upstairs now, so he didn't come in tonight. There we go. I'll set this off to the side and let that start drying. And then we can come back over here to our little chick. So we're gonna have our feather, our little tail. I think we're gonna leave it white, our chicken. I think I like it. All right, so let's get some glue. Glue down his little head. And his feather and his tail. I guess they're all feathers. They don't really have tails, but I'm calling this one a tail. Hi, Tamara. And then we're gonna go ahead and glue down our 3D eggs. My goodness. You guys, are we like, we're gonna be out of time. We're gonna be done. I got two projects out for us, thinking that it would take me the whole time, and I don't think that's gonna happen. I don't really have any details to put on here. I mean, there's a few things we can do still, but. All right. So I'm gonna let him sit over here. Oops, I moved him. See what I mean? It dries really quick, but you do wanna let it sit flat for a few seconds, probably a minute or two before you start moving things around. Now for this, I'm gonna try to put it just on the wood, because if I try to put it on the background piece, there's gonna be way too much glue. Ah, and then I got way too much glue anyways. It just came squirting out of there. So what I'm gonna do is just stick it onto my towel. I always paint with a towel, and I kind of took some of it off of there. And then set it down. Whoops. Careful though, my fingers are sticking to it and then it'll break the wood. Farm Fresh Eggs. All right. So then I'm gonna take this and find out exactly where I want it to sit, pretty much like that. I'm gonna stick some glue on this stand part of it, stick, handle, whatever you wanna call it, with a sign to the sign. And then, definitely got too much glue on here. Got the glue up too high. Probably about like that, I think. And I'm gonna let that sit there for a second so that it dries right where I want it to be. It'll slide around for a second. So let me show you my bucket again. It'll sit right in here. And then it'll stand just like so to be your little shelf sitter. And then in just a minute, I'll show you it with that in there. There's a few little details that we can do on our chicken still. Let me see what I can find. So all of these are interchangeable. The original is the basket. So this is the basket, and I have a Halloween insert in there, but the Halloween insert will go in any of these, just like the chicken insert will go into any of these. So this is one base. There's like 5 or 6 bases on the website. This is another base, which is a little wagon set. Isn't that cute? So again, the Halloween one can go on here if you want the Halloween one on here. I put mine together a little bit wrong, so I have to wiggle it on. But see, you can interchange it to this, or show you it with the bucket. You can stick it. Oops, the base came off. I'll probably glue the base on these. There you go. You could stick your witch or your Halloween stuff in the bucket if you wanted to. I just thought the bucket would be super cute with the, so this is a set that's on there. There's a bunch of different inserts and bases on the website. I thought the bucket would look cute with the chickens. All right, I think that's dry and good. Oh no, this didn't dry exactly how I want it yet. So let me hold it a minute. I think with it sitting on the towel, it wasn't exactly level or flat. And then I can show you it in just a minute. It's almost done wiggling around. Let me hold it a second longer. Again, if you're going to do that, just be careful because it's MDF. It's thin. It's 1/8. It will break if you're not gentle with it, but it just makes it look even more real to have that around the edge. All right, I think I'm good there. So then there is our adorable little chicken. And our bucket. How cute is that, friends? Do you like it? I think it turned out good. We can do a few little details. I don't think I want to do anything more on this. I might do like a highlight or two here and there, but I'm going to leave that pretty much how it is. We can go ahead and do some fun things on here, though. Let's do, let's see. I don't even know what I want to do. I like it just how it is. What do you guys think? Guys, love it. Thank you. I'm thinking like what we could do, a few like things on the edges of this, but I don't want to mess it up. I really like it. So I just put a little bit of the darker brown on here, and I'm just gonna kind of rub it alongside. Didn't do so much like I wanted it to. It's gonna rub it alongside the edge of his head just to give him a little bit of dimension. So, because it didn't do what I wanted it to, I'm going to go back in with a lighter color and just kind of try to blend it a little bit more. Now I got to work around his eye and the white parts on him, darn it. I got a little carried away, I guess. My sponge is kind of deteriorating. Usually I can just run it right along the edge and just give it like a little bit of an outline or like a shadow. See what I kind of did there? It's still a little bit darker. It didn't blend as much as I wanted it to. All right, what else can we do? We can do something similar to the edges of these, maybe with, I'm gonna try the warm buff on the edges. Just kind of gives it some shadow or outline, some dimension. It makes it look more real, I think. But you can keep it just one solid color if you want to. Try it on this side. See the trick? It would have been better if I would have done this part before I glued it down. But I like to lately get my pieces all glued together to see how I want to finish them, instead of finishing them before I see it all together, if that makes sense. That just kind of makes it look a little bit more real. So I'm gonna try and do the same thing right around this feather in the middle without getting it all over his belly. Wing feather, whatever you want to call it here. And then maybe a little bit around like the top part of them too. I want this to be more blended right here. I feel like it's just kind of pretty stark right there. So I'm just going back over it with some white to kind of blend that warm buff out a little bit. Because it doesn't blend, you know, you can't really blend unless you've got wet paint. So just adding that little bit of white back on there just lets it blend better. And then I did mess this up a little bit. It's all right, I was able to fix that piece. I'm gonna do a little bit of touch-ups on my eggs real quick. We got just about 10 more minutes until the next presenter is up. If you're on the Craft Around the Clock group page, if you're not, give us a follow over there. We've got live crafting all week long. And when we're not live, we have replays in the group. So there's always something fun to catch over there. And if you're new to my page, I would love it if you give me a follow. I go live at least once a week. Trying to do more. Preston's in driver's training right now and it is sports season. So this week it just didn't work out to go live any more than the one time. But I am going to try to do 2 or 3 times a week for the rest of the year. He actually gets to go do his first drive tomorrow. So he's nervous about that, but he's a good driver. He's been driving on job sites for a long time. All right, just brighten up that blue a little bit. I felt like that was still a little bit light. But do you guys like that? Up close, you can see the difference, like the outline, but you really can't tell from a distance. But I think it looks really good. The only other thing I might do is add some like speckles to the eggs. I don't really want them to be polka dots though, so I gotta think about how I wanna do that. You could use a toothbrush to like kind of speckle it, but again, if I would have thought about it, I would have done that before I put it together, because otherwise you're gonna get the speckles all over the whole everything, the chicken, the eggs, everything. You like it, Tamara? Good. I'm so glad to hear that. All right, guys, I guess that's it. I don't really want to do any more outlines or anything to him. I want him to look natural. So let me stick them back together real quick. Where'd my base go? There it is. And show you him. So there's tonight's project. Super cute, fun. Thank you, thank you, thank you. All right, guys, thanks so much for hanging out with me. Stick around. The next presenter will be up in the next 5-ish minutes. If you're new to me, give me a follow. I will talk to you guys soon. Have a great day. Bye, everybody.